coming to you live from the Eastern Shore Toyota and Hyundai Studios. The Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report, presented by Alpha. Here are your hosts, Coach Rick Cleveland and Coach Mark Lassiter.
Good morning and welcome to the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report. We are presented by our good friends at Alpha, and we are coming to you live from the Eastern Shore Toyota and Hyundai Studios, located on the beautiful rolling hills of Timber Creek Golf Club right here in Mobile, Alabama. I can't do Jim Nance. I just can't do it. But good morning, Mark Lassiter.
Hang on. Good morning. I'm out of practice. I hadn't been here in a couple of weeks. I was under the weather.
And good morning, Rob Bradley.
Good morning. Good to have. Thank you for having me here.
Well, we're glad to have you here. And, you know, this is, you know, Mark, the portal is so active in college football. We decided to go to the portal. And, boy, the NIL may kill us eventually. But, man, we are so excited to bring in the host of the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report, a guy that we both love dearly. You see eye to eye with him. I've got a little...
I'm taller than he is.
Well, I'm just bigger chest-wise. But we are so excited as you hear us from the rolling plains of Auburn to the championship city of Tuscaloosa to Little River Canyon in Mentone, Alabama, all the way down to the port city of Mobile, Alabama, and all sites in between. It is our absolute honor and privilege to introduce the new host of Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report, the founder, the originator of Southern Fairways Golf Radio. He and his compadre, well, Joey Johnson's his compadre, too. But those guys have a tremendous radio show every Saturday on these stations. But we are so glad to bring in our host and the mediator for you and I.
Yes.
Randy Bergen. And, Randy, we are so glad to have you here. And we're so excited about things that we can do now that we've got an expert radio man in and two old worn-out coaches. We're excited to have you here, Paul.
Coach, I got to tell you, I'm excited. I am really excited to be here. Okay, this is going to be a lot of fun. It is a, it's an opportunity to spend more time with y'all. Certainly an opportunity to spend. I don't get to spend a lot of time with a guy I see eye to eye with. Okay, I'm just going to tell you.
That's right. But now I understand. I understand completely.
But no, I am. It's going to be a lot of fun. We got a lot of great things that are going to be happening, and I couldn't be happier to be with y'all. Of course, we all make a great little team here anyway. So, yeah, I'm excited. Thank you for the opportunity. And, man, what a great place to be today, huh? Timber Creek Golf Club in Daphne. And they've got some neat things that are going on. We got a lot to get into today. But here at Timber Creek, Rob's going to be with us, the owner and general manager here, to tell us a little bit later on what's going on down here. They've got something. If you're a golfer and coach, Mark, I know that you being the head coach, golf coach there at Bayside, he's got something you might want to participate in.
Just learning about it. It's beautiful out. First of all, this place is beautiful anyway. I love this golf course and love Rob and the kind of person he is. And you come here, you feel like family when you walk in the door, and that's what this place is all about. And then you come out here, it's kind of chilly out, but what a beautiful morning.
No doubt.
And I saw my buddy Jeff Williams heading out to play around the golf, my buddy from many, many years coaching. He and I were just telling everybody, we started coaching together in 1987.
Oh, my goodness.
And that's the first time he and I coached together back in Alexander City. We were both working for Steve Savarese then. And over the years, our lives have intermingled and coached together and coached against one another. And it's just good to see him and his son, JT, out playing this morning.
It is good to see Jeff. And he's just another one of us old offensive line coaches.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's just a camaraderie there that goes there. You know, that guys, today is a huge day for us here in Mobile. Senior Bowl Saturday, and the entire nation, we get to showcase a beautiful new stadium out at the University of South Alabama, Hancock Whitney Stadium. My buddy Jim Nagy has just done an amazing job of getting everything put in place and has brought some wonderful, wonderful coaching staffs in. And He's brought the Detroit Lions in and the New York Jets in to coach these kids, and we've got four or five kids from the Mobile area. It's a big, big day for us here in Mobile, Alabama, and we're so proud of the Senior Bowl and what it's done for us.
Absolutely. And, you know, if you get right down to the real level of it, when you were saying these are big kids.
Yeah.
They're still babies. You know, they're in their young 20s. They're trying to make decisions. Yeah. But this is an opportunity for them to do something very special. It's life-changing.
Absolutely.
And I talk about not the guys that are the superstars. Yeah. I'm talking about the guys who – let's bring this guy. We want to get a look at this guy.
Yeah.
We want to find out what he can really do.
Yeah.
He comes in and has a good week. He may go from a fourth-round pick to a third or second.
Yeah.
And it's like, or he may be a guy who may not even be on the books
and
step in and be a fifth- or sixth-round pick. And all of a sudden, look what happened to Tom Brady. He wasn't even hardly on anybody's board, and all of a sudden, you know, he's the GOAT. And so you never know what's going to happen with these kids. So it's, you know, and we've all coached in, you know, we've coached in these all-star games.
Right.
You know, and some of the, I remember coaching an all-star game in 2003, a kid from Jeff Davis came out. He was a late pickup because one of our kids couldn't come, so we picked him up. He came out and practiced with us that week, got into the game as a safety. After the ball game, the coach from Middle Tennessee State offers him a scholarship. He went and got a four-year education because of that opportunity. So that's, to me, that's what the Senior Bowl is all about.
Randy's hometown is Bay Minette, Alabama.
Yep.
And probably one of the great stories coming out of Senior Bowl is the young man.
Gosh, no, you should not have done that.
I should have thrown it to him. He's a defensive end, big defensive end.
Wallace Gilbert.
He was not on anybody's radar.
No.
Senior Bowl brings him in.
Goes to Alabama, plays.
Well, that was a high school all-star game. Wasn't
it?
I'm sorry. These all-star games are the ones that really highlight those
guys. Right.
But he comes back and plays in the Senior Bowl.
He does.
After nobody really
and had a big career in the NFL.
Oh, yeah, he did.
No doubt.
And then gave back to his community. Comes back and gives back to his community. Think about that.
Yeah.
Think about the lives that got changed because of opportunity.
Absolutely.
You know, that's so many times we forget, and I don't let me get on a rant here about too many times people out there today don't mind ruining other people's lives. It bothers me. What about these great stories like that? Why don't we do sensationalism on that, you know, and really get excited about the Wallace Gilberries of the world? What a great kid. He's a fantastic young man, by the way.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Just as a golf pro sitting here amongst all the football people, I have to echo that, Coach. And I think if we learn from a society standpoint that we come from a plentiful mentality rather than a scarcity mentality.
Yes.
And if you build somebody up, it's only going to help you.
That's right.
And if you tear somebody down, it's still going to hurt you.
That's right, Rob.
So I think as coaches, that's why we're so passionate about it, because we see the reality of a kid getting hurt.
That's right.
And we see the reality of a kid getting lifted up. So, you know, with the parents and the other coaches out there listening, just keep that in the forefront of your policy.
The whole philosophy of this show.
Exactly, Randy. I was thinking the same thing.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, 20 years ago we came up with that, and it was a God thing. It's something during our quiet time, you know, build people up. Don't be a part of tearing them down. And that's you're right, Randy. Thank you for mentioning that. You know, and I want to play off of what you're saying, because it's something that's heavy in the news right now, and we're going to end up covering a whole lot of stuff on this show. We're going to be primarily a high school show, but boy, we're going to cover everything. I mean, there's not anything we're not going to cover in sports. And this thing with Auburn, there's some people really trying to hurt that man.
Yes.
They're really trying to hurt that man. And I don't buy it. I don't buy it at all. And you know, in Auburn's had 27 head coaches. 27.
Wow.
Now, if Auburn decides to terminate Brian Harsin, which I pray that they don't, that doesn't happen.
Me too.
He will be the 10th coach of those 27 who is terminated after 1 year on the job.
How do you do that? How do you bring somebody in, pay them that kind of money, and then you don't even give them an opportunity to go out and recruit and to build a team Okay, not just players, but your coaching staff as well. You got to get the right team. And guys, y'all are coaches. You know what that how important it is to get the right coaching staff in there to build the mentality and everything that you want for that team, the future for that team. How do you do it in 1 year and then let the guy go?
He hung the signs on the door yet.
No. It's a shame. Here's the thing. You know, to me, in our country, we have gotten to the point where it's guilty before ever anything ever gets decided. It's up to the board. It's Auburn University's job to check these guys out, not the media.
Exactly.
It's not them. And I think Harson's going to do a great job. I think they'll be fine, and he'll do a great job.
All right, guys, got to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to head to Gulf Shores. We'll talk with Coach Mark Hudson as PSR returns right after this.
Welcome back to the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report. This segment presented by Green & Phillips Attorneys at Law. Now, back to the show.
Man, that's some good stuff right there. Welcome back to the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report. I'm Randy Bergen, along with Coach Rick Cleveland, Coach Mark Lassiter, hanging out here at Timber Creek Golf Club in beautiful Daphne, Alabama. The owner, general manager here, Mr. Rob Bradley, he is hanging out with us. Guys, I jumped the gun. Rick, you give me one job, and I jump the gun. Okay, I'm reading quick here. We got Coach Mark Hudson. He's coming on at the bottom of the hour.
Correct.
Okay, it'll be fun to talk with him. But guys, we were talking about what's going on the campus there at Auburn, and with Coach Harsin and the thoughts there and all of that going on. If you're Coach Harsin, what's going through your mind? What's going through your mind right now, Coach?
I mean, I'm sitting here thinking, why are y'all not letting me do my job?
Exactly.
You know, it's different than Coach Harsin. I read a big article on him and Coach Malzahn. They're two different entities. They're two different people completely. Harsin's more business. I'm going to do it this way. He's not a – Gus is a family atmosphere. He creates a more of a family type of atmosphere when he coaches. Always has. Harsin's different. He's a different person. It doesn't mean he doesn't love people. I'm just saying he's different in how he approaches it like a business, and he takes it like that. And you've got to let him get his kind of people in, because right now he's playing with Gus's players and Gus's staff who's there. It's a little bit different mentality. It doesn't mean it's wrong. Gus was successful at what he did, you know, and Brian, I think, would be too, but I don't think some people like the way he's doing it, and they want him out. And I think that I'm afraid that they have created a character assassination on the guy, which I don't know if it's true or not. I don't think it's true.
You know, Mark, when Coach Saban came to Alabama, and I think he's got a lot of the same intangibles that Coach Saban has. I really do. And as far as his come-to-work ethic and the way he wants to run the program. When Coach Saban came to Alabama, if I'm not – correct me if I'm wrong – he fired two coordinators his first year. He had to get his staff, after he had worked with them for a year, he had to see exactly what he wanted as far as the chemistry of that staff. He's the greatest college coach that in my lifetime. I think he's the greatest one that we've ever had. Now, I loved Coach Bryant. I was one of his disciples, so to speak, as a kid. It's a different time. It's a different era. And in Coach Bryant's day, I think he was the greatest. Today, I think Nick Saban is the greatest. And I think Brian Harsin has some of those intangibles that people don't necessarily see unless you're there and you play for him. He's not the goody-goody two-shoes guys as far as, you know, let's go have a popsicle together. You know, let's go to the weight room. Let's get to work. Every day is a day to get better.
Derek Hall said it best, the defensive end for Auburn,
right,
when he made the statement, they hired a coach, not a friend.
Absolutely.
And that's what they did. Now, a coach can be a friend, but first he's got to be your coach.
Yeah.
It's a different entity. Mm. And so I think that you got to give guy more than 1 year.
No,
come
that
on, people.
I mean,
all they're doing is harming Auburn University.
That's Coach. That's my thoughts that I'm listening to y'all, and that my daughter's graduated from there, and I just have a lot of affinity towards the way the institution of Auburn They have a lot of high standards. And I just caution the folks that are involved in this to keep that in the forefront.
Right.
Make sure that you handle yourselves where you're proud to have that Auburn name with the way that you're handling yourselves. Because when it's all said and done, it's a reflection of the kids and the institution and the culture you're trying to provide to the kids.
Right. You said your daughter's a graduate of Auburn?
Yes, sir.
I got one of those, too. And I can tell you right now, if Katie, if we had Katie on the show, I guarantee you Katie would lay it on the line with the Auburn people. I can promise you. Now, yep. I don't even know if Katie likes Harsin or not, but she is Auburn through and through. And I guarantee you that's eating Katie up, all this going on. As it is all... I think it's eaten up a lot of Auburn people, and mm-hmm. I just hope that today brings some peace and tranquility to this. I really do. I want to get to something, guys. You know, we got the state indoor track meet going on at the Crossplex in Birmingham. You and I know it as Fair Park.
Right.
That's what it was
right.
forever.
For years
yeah.
and years and years.
But they have built a beautiful, beautiful complex there, and we have the state indoor going on there. And my buddy Pat Galley left yesterday with a boatload of kids. But we've already crowned some state champions in the indoor state track meet. And Scottsboro, Winfield, Northridge, and locally Mobile Christian won a state championship yesterday in the indoor. So that's boys and girls going on. And good luck to all the local teams that are there. I don't know exactly everybody's there. We'll see it when we see the point system going up. But you people in the Birmingham area, if you get a chance, go out and to the Crossplex and watch these children. They have worked all summer long to prepare for this. But good luck to my buddy Pat Galley.
Absolutely.
Man, I'm just telling you, I'm so excited for him.
I know our kids from Bayside left and went.
Right.
Our coach, Joe Swaggart, loaded his bunch up and took off. He's got probably, if he's not the best hurdler in Alabama, in 3A, he may be in the whole state. I think he's going. He's got a scholarship to go run at Alabama.
Yeah.
Patrick Daves, who should win the state championship today if he didn't already win it yesterday.
Yep.
I haven't seen the schedule of events.
Yep.
Patrick Daves is going to do it, and Coach Swagger's just done a great job. And a lot of these coaches, we don't talk about them enough because cross country coaches, yep. indoor track coaches, you don't talk about them enough because it's not one of those sports that brings in a lot of money.
It's not the glitzy,
thing.
Glitzy,
but you ought to watch those kids prepare.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable what they do and how it's all divided up on our track and what Pat Galley. I watched Pat Galley when I was at UMS.
Yeah.
Was just amazed at, and kids flock to him.
That's
what's amazing.
Yeah.
And there's something to be said for that, and there's a reason why. Because not because he's really good and knowledgeable, because he loves kids. And because of that, kids want to run for him. They want to be a part of that. And I think that's a big, big deal. So I hope if you're in Birmingham, go out and watch those kids run. It's amazing to watch those kids run up there. And now let me ask you this. Fair Park, isn't that where the old racetrack used
that
to
was.
Be?
Red
that's
Farmer?
Where Jones Valley, that was their home football field.
Home football field.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you right now, you go out there and you'd see Red Farmer,
yes.
Bobby Allison,
yes,
and those
right.
guys running that track.
Trying to run that track.
Then you go in Fair Park and it was cold and damp. And boy, I'm going to tell you, you get some Cap Brown would just whip your fanny on a basketball court. So it was,
I used to go in there for this when I was coaching wrestling. We'd have the state wrestling championships in there and big auditorium. We had three mats laid out, and now it's in Pelham, and I think they have six mats.
I
think that's what it is. But anyway, that's Fair Park. A lot of great memories.
And, guys, basketball postseason starts this week. It really can start Monday, but most teams will start play Tuesday. We'll have all kind of basketball postseason. We'll end up with a state champions in all seven classifications. As a matter of fact, we're going to talk to the coach of the number one ranked 7A basketball team in Alabama, David Alexander. He's the guy with the beard. He's got a wonderful manicured beard. Coaching at Baker High School.
Well, they've got a really good team.
Oh, they do, and they got a player that everybody in the country is going to be looking at here pretty soon. A guy by the name of LeBaron Phelan, and let me tell you, he's a sophomore. We coached against Dennis Watley when he was,
I remember
Phillips High School.
Yeah,
this guy don't take no backseat to nobody. I'm just telling you, he's something special. So I imagine, you know, there'll be a big hullabaloo about Alabama and Auburn recruit that guy pretty soon.
Probably so.
He is something special.
Where did Enos Whatley play high school ball?
Phillips High School.
Phillips High School.
You can't get me on that one now. I mean, that's I had to sit in the gym and watch him scorch us. I'm telling you. I mean, he scorched us. And he'd look over at the bench and just shake his head.
He was in my health class at Alabama.
Really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
That was pretty neat.
That's pretty cool.
He was really... really a good – he was a good guy.
Yeah.
He was a really nice kid.
He could play.
Yeah, he could.
He could play. And then I want to mention a kid from Sylacauga. Wayne Brasher has been a – he listens to on Fox Sports Central Alabama, 98.3 in Sylacauga. And he and his wife, Wayne and Marty Brasher – their son, Brantley Brasher, has signed a baseball scholarship with Bethel University in McKenzie, Tennessee. He's a middle infielder, really plays multiple positions for Coach Jeff Bell there at Sylacauga. Their coaches describe him as the ideal teammate, a great teammate. Congratulations to Brantley Brasher, Sylacauga High School, headed to Bethel University.
All right, listen, we're going to take a quick time out. Now, when we come back, we will talk to Coach Mark Hudspeth of Gulf Shores Football. He's the head coach. We'll talk with him right after this. Don't touch that dial. This is PSR.
Welcome back to the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report. The Pops Market communication lines are open at 251-343-0106. Now, back to the show.
And we welcome you back to the Prep Sports Report. I certainly want to welcome all of our friends on board with us listening in on great radio stations in Central Alabama. It's Fox Sports Central Alabama on 98.3 FM in Birmingham, Montgomery, Prattville, Auburn, Lake Martin, Sylacauga, that whole Central Alabama area. Glad to have you on board with us. Also along the Gulf Coast of Alabama, Mississippi, and Florida. You've got us tuned in to FM Talk 106.5. You know, you can always keep us with you by getting the FM Talk 106.5 app. It's simple, it's free, and it only takes seconds to upload, and or by installing the iHeartRadio app and search Radio Alabama. Glad to have you on board with us. I'm Randy Bergen, along with Coach Mark Glaster, Coach Rick Cleveland, and the owner and proprietor here at Timber Creek Golf Club, where we are broadcasting live from our good friend, Mr. Rob Bradley. Time to go to our Pops Market Midtown communication line and welcome in the head football coach for Gulf Shores, Coach Mark Hudspeth. Coach, how you doing, pal?
Hey, we're doing great this morning. Fix to play a little flag football this morning with my son. So we've got a big game coming up here about 9 o'clock.
You know, Mark, thanks for joining us here on Prep Sports Report. We have, of course, we followed your career for a long time, us doing a lot of Sun Belt stuff and when you were at Lafayette. And, just a wonderful, wonderful guy that has had a lot of success everywhere he's been. Was at Mississippi State and then at Austin Peay, was OVC Coach of the Year. And, Mark, you jumped on a Bears, what you did. You jumped in this high school stuff, and you go to the beach where very few people have had a lot of success. And I know it's been an exciting time for you, pal. Congratulations on being there. And I want to talk to you a little bit this morning about you doing things a little bit different than what other coaches have done. You've kind of assembled a college staff, and it really seems to be working well for you, Mark.
Well, okay, it's been an exciting time, as you can imagine. You know, living here in Gulf Shores, you know, a place you really, it's a destination spot to come vacation. And finally, me and my wife just said, "Hey, well, what if we just live here year round?" And I said, "That sounds like a pretty good idea." Had a chance to take this job, and it's really been a great fit. And yet, we have tried to do things differently. You know, our superintendent and our school board have really bought into the ideas I've given them. What I'm trying to incorporate is a college, and I tell our players this and everybody is, you know, we're not a Power Five team, obviously not even close. We're a 5A high school football team, but that don't mean you have to operate that way. You know, we're trying to operate at a very high level. Our school allows us to we get our kids until 9:30 every morning. So our kids arrive at 6:45 every day for team workouts, team runs, team meetings, position meetings, and then we feed them a team breakfast. Then they go to class and they come back after school. dinner for practice, and then we feed them a dinner to go. So they've allowed us to do a lot of cool things, and the best thing about it, they've allowed me to hire a great staff. And so I wanted to hire coaches that coached, and they don't teach. My two coordinators don't teach classes, so we're able to game plan, put all of our efforts into our student athletes. And so I hired Kenny Edfield, as you already knew, as our offensive coordinator, longtime Division One offensive coordinator. Brian Van Gorder was our defensive coordinator last year, and then I just hired Paul Rhodes as our defensive coordinator this year. And not only is it a great opportunity for our players to get to play for guys like this that coach at the highest level, imagine our current coaches on your staff that get to grow and learn from these types of coaches. It just makes them better coaches. And it makes me a better coach having such a good staff here. So I've been really excited about it.
You know, talk a little bit about your feeder programs too, Mark. And I think that's a neat thing, and that's really the lifeblood of any high school program. Are the feeder programs, and talk a little bit about how you run those programs.
Well, you know, every school, you know, you got your elementary, you got your middle, high school. Here with our middle school program, I'm personally working out our guys in afternoons, the sixth and seventh graders, which are upcoming seventh and eighth graders. And so I work them out after 3:30 to 4:30. I mean, they get the same workout gear that our varsity gets. Our entire varsity staff is in there training those guys. And then our middle school is led by head football coach Eddie Garfinkel. I know you're familiar with Eddie. You know, longtime defensive coordinator, Jacksonville State, head coach Birmingham Southern. And so, you know, he is doing a phenomenal job also, being a great resource to the middle school coaches. And, you know, if you're a coach, you know, what a great opportunity to be able to coach for some of these guys and to grow and develop. And then we want to help our current assistant coaches get head jobs. We want to develop them to where they go get head coaching jobs and use the experience they've gotten here to go somewhere else. We're trying to make everybody grow, and especially with our players. We had seven players now that's had a chance to go to the next level. Whether it's Division One or Division Three, that doesn't matter to me. I want to give our kids opportunities.
We're visiting with Gulf Shores High School football coach, Coach Mark Hudspeth. Coach Mark, I know you got a question.
Yeah, Coach, thanks for joining us this morning, and really pleased that you could spend a few little bit of time with us. I wanted to ask you, with the vast amount of work y'all are doing in the mornings and with all your football players, how are you able to work this in with, like, I know the basketball team and the baseball team? How are you guys working that together with those other kids and other sports and making it to where they can still get their strength training and still compete in other sports?
Yeah, that's the best thing about it, is we get to work our guys out in the mornings in the weight room, and then, you know, they do the after school practicing, whether it's wrestling, whether it's baseball, basketball. And so that allows us for year-round training, and to me, that helps all, you know, everybody. You know, just like they say, rise the tide raises all boats. And so we're trying to, you know, help all our programs. We work well together here, and you know, and we really don't have that many that play other sports here. We've got a lot of guys only playing one sport, which I like kids that like to play other sports that are competitive.
And so right.
That's something that I definitely love when kids play other sports.
You know, Mark, you've been in some places that are really, really good places for high school football as a college coach. Lafayette, you go to Clarksville, you were in Starkville, but now you're at the beach. You know, most people come to the beach for vacation, and you've got to assemble a football team that is used to having a culture of a vacation location. How tough is that for a head football coach?
Well, you know, at first it was a little bit of trying to figure out all the logistics, because I'll say this, in the summertime, you know, we're very fortunate that our young men, you know, players, they have lots of employment opportunities. And so, you know, we bring our guys in early in the summer. We 4 days a week in the summer, so we're working them really good. But then we let them go after morning workouts, morning conditioning and all that. And, you know, a lot of these guys are, you know, on the boats, charter boats, and they're working at the amusement parks and at the water parks. And they make a lot of good money in the summertime, and so. But it's a great opportunity for these young men to make some money, and you know, with this economy down here, it's been great for me to go out and meet people and raise some resources, because we've just converted our facilities, I feel like, some of the worst maybe in the state to now maybe some of the best in the state. We've got immaculate practice fields. Our football field house, our city put $500,000 into the renovation of it. Offices, meeting room, staff room, locker rooms. I mean, it's carpeted, graphics. And you can see all this online on our Twitter page, GSHS Dolphins. That's Gulf Shore High School Dolphins, GSHS Dolphins. Check us out. I think we're doing some good stuff, especially with our social media. I think our social media pages, we're doing it better than a lot of FBS programs. And so we're just trying to do things at a high level and have fun doing it.
You know, I hear that wind whipping, and we got about a minute and a half to go here, Mark. And the thing, you've jumped in now to 5A Region 1. And I know we talk about it at UMS all the time. You know, this is a pretty tough region of football, and I know you guys are excited about being in there.
Well, I don't know if the word excited is what you want to hear. You know, obviously, Terry and you guys, they've been doing it a long time, the success they've had there. They sort of set the standard down here. And so then you got Jack French at Faith Academy. There's some outstanding coaching down here. And I think that resonates all throughout the coast cities, because people want to move south. They want to come down here and live and get a head coaching job. So there's lots of good coaches in this district, in this region. It's tough. We were in the 6A region. It was really tough. This 5A region is just as tough. And a lot of, even Viger moving up from the 4A, went in the state championship. Yeah. So, you know, we've got our work cut out for us. We just need every advantage that we can find to help close the gap between you guys, because there has been a huge gap between everybody else in Gulf Shores in the past.
Well, Mark, there's no doubt that they hired the right guy. And, good luck to you guys, and thanks for taking time out on a Saturday morning when you're going. I know you got a bunch of gadget plays you're going to work on that you use that flag football for.
We picked all kind of rub routes on these guys. We picked to see if we can have some fun this morning. And that's the best thing about it. I'm getting to spend some time with my kids. Right now I'm not on an official visit tour and worried about that dang portal right now.
That's right. That's exactly right. Will you take care, Mark? We look forward to seeing you soon. Good luck. God bless. And, hey, have some fun out there today, okay?
You got it. Hey, guys, have a great day. Thanks for having us on. Go Dolphins.
Thank you, buddy.
Take care.
There you go. Coach Mark Hutchman, head football coach for the Dolphins of Gulf Shores, man. You know what? I'll tell you, I like that mentality he's got going on down there. That is a... you're coaches. I'm not. I think there's some positivity to that. You tell me how you feel about that, Coach.
I got some mixed feelings, Mike, to be honest with you. I really do. There's, you know, the thing that bothers me about what's going on at Gulf Shores is I'm seeing a lot of kids transfer in there. And, you know, this is a program that builds programs up, so we're not going to be a part of tearing anything down. But we're seeing too much of that transfer in high schools all over the state of Alabama. And I don't understand.
Well, there's a mentality over in the pan over in Florida that is a weird mentality that
they
you
got
go play.
A different rule. They
well,
got a different
they do.
Rule.
They do. Maybe we talk about that.
Yeah,
we can talk about that.
But Mark Hudspeth is a heck of a football coach,
no doubt,
and will do a great job.
There's no doubt about it. Hey, we're going to take a quick timeout. When we come back, hey, let's talk with Coach Rob.
Yep.
Yeah,
yep.
We'll be right back.
The Charleston Gas Lanterns Prep Sports Report is live every Saturday morning beginning at 8. Now, back to the show.
Oh, my goodness. Welcome back to Prep Sports Report right here on the Prep Sports Report Network. How about that, Rick?
That's pretty good.
You like that?
Yeah,
all right.
I
got to tell you, I got kind of caught up there. The bump music, you know that I'm a big Steely Dan, a big Boss Skaggs fan, and I kind of got caught up there. And the whole reason, Rob, if you didn't know this, the reason I wanted so bad to come be a part of this is just for the bump music.
Just for
okay?
the music.
Because on my show, we're playing like Bruno Mars. We're playing. We're doing all that.
I've been to talk to you about that.
Yeah, I know. But we are glad that you're here with us. Hey, I want to remind you, Premier Collision is your your home for all your auto body and collision problems. Good quality parts, professional staff, and the best prices in town. Give Chris Garris, our friend Chris, a call at 251-478-4500. They are located at 1177 Sledge Drive in Mobile, Alabama. It is Premier Collision.
You know, and while you're talking about that, we got a buddy, local attorney Braxton Counts, is a lobbyist in Montgomery, Alabama, and Washington, D.C. Braxton has joined forces with former Tennessee Congressman Jimmy Duncan, and their job is to assist you with all types of governmental affair problems. Both of these gentlemen have great influence in both Montgomery and Washington, and many of you rely on either the state or the federal government for your businesses. Braxton Counts and Jimmy Duncan can put you in front of the right people to assist you. It's all about relationships, as our buddy Steve Savarese preached to us for years and years and years in all those meetings before we went to Burger King for breakfast, Mark.
And did y'all wear the crowns? just wondering.
We had a $2 limit. So okay.
You got two?
I got the dollar special. You know, so it is all about those relationships, and both Braxton and Jimmy have those connections to assist you. Give our friend Braxton Counts a call at 251-476-9900.
Yeah, very good. I'm Randy Bergen, along with Coach Mark Glasser, Coach Rick Cleveland. We're hanging out here at Timber Creek Golf Club in Daphne, Alabama, where the owner and general manager here, our good friend Rob Bradley, has been hanging out with us. Rob, you've got something going on, and we're going to get back into football here in just a few moments, but you got something going on here at Timber Creek that is unlike anywhere else along the Gulf Coast, and it is your range called Top Tracer Range now here at Timber Creek. Tell us a little bit about it.
I appreciate the opportunity, and I've really enjoyed the show and getting to rub elbows with some old friends I haven't seen in a while. And we're so excited here, Randy, that we have Top Tracer. And for folks that are out there that are trying to understand what that concept is, picture Topgolf. And it's the same company. They're affiliated with each other. Top Tracer is an affiliate of Topgolf. Some people were even saying it's a little better than Topgolf because what you can do is you can hit all your irons and get all the measurements of launch angles and spin rates and distances and landing and roll and all that good stuff and have it transferred over to your phone and conveniently look at it while you're playing. But also you can do approach challenges. You can do long drive contests closest to the pins.
And listen, there's some other games you can play too. And, Coach, I think both you coaches are going to love this. You can go fish. Okay, you play go fish.
Or you hit you an alligator.
There you go.
Get you a whale. Yep. So
it is a ton of fun.
It is. The kids love that game, don't they, Coach? Randy coaches. Everybody's a coach here today.
Absolutely.
And with that being said, though, you can do. You can play long drives. You can play close to the pins. You can play second approach shot. You can play Pebble Beach.
Yeah.
You can play Torrey Pines.
Torrey Pines. It really is neat. It's something you need to check out if you're in the area. Come by Timber Creek, get them to show it to you. Got 10 bays out here. It is at heaters.
Well, the weather's always good because we got a cover over it.
That's right.
We've got heaters. It's always sunny and dry.
Well, certainly check it out here at Timber Creek, and you can set up one of those bay areas or a tee time by dialing
251-621-9000.
That is awesome. And it is addictive.
May I interject one thought
sure
real quick?
Listen
to all the coaches. I work with a lot of top 100 PGA teaching professionals throughout the country, and one of the things that they've come to understand is that folks that play many sports wind up being the best golfers. So I think that's also true the other way, and that is that if we get our kids playing multiple sports like we used to do intuitively, when we ride our bike, we had a basketball in the basket, we had a football in the basket, we had a glove on the other side, a bat somewhere in between, and we played all these things, and we came out to be pretty good athletes.
That's right.
So just think about your linebackers and your DBs. If you had them playing a little tennis, how they're going back and forth, laterally back and forth.
I can tell you that's what we talk a lot about when we go play golf with Coach Rick Cleveland, is how soft his hands are around the green and putting. So you're absolutely right. You're absolutely
right. Thank you for that opportunity.
Oh, yeah.
Good,
hey, one, real quick, a little sad news on the January 31st.
Yep.
Lost a Hall of Fame coach from Realtown.
Sure did. Dwayne Webster passed away, and Mark, goodness gracious alive, what can you say about Dwayne Webster? He was a man way before his time. He was doing things that it was just tough to stop. And Jackie O'Neill played for him there at Real Town, a legend and a member of the Alabama High School Athletic Association Hall of Fame. Just a good, good guy. And, buddy, he loved cream corn more than any man I've ever known. I can tell you.
You caught me so off guard on that.
He told me one time he loved a restaurant in Montgomery that I love, Martin's. And he said, "Cleve, we're going to go to Martin's, and all we're going to eat is cream corn." Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sweet man. But I'm telling you, he was tough as nails when he needed to be, Mark.
Yeah, he was. I remember I was in Alex City, I think, toward the end of his career,
yep.
If I'm not mistaken. And Real Town, just down the road, yeah. Not too far away. Yeah. And, folks, if y'all have never been to Real Town, it is a beautiful little area.
Yeah.
Wonderful school there. They got great people. In fact, one of my former assistant coaches is now the head coach there. Jared Wooten's the head coach at Real Town right now.
He's a Real Town guy too. He played for Dwayne.
He did.
Yeah.
And Jared's there. And but when Dwayne was, you know, Dwayne I think was there most of his life.
Yeah.
And then Jackie O'Neill grew up, played there, came back as an assistant coach there, then became the head coach, and then retired from there. So I mean, not much turnover in Real Town, no. Alabama. Folks go there because it's a great place to raise a family.
Yeah.
And I think Dwayne had such a huge impact on so many kids that that's why he's a Hall of Famer, and that's why his legacy will live on for many generations because of what he taught those kids and those coaches and what then they were able to share with theirs, and then their kids will share with other kids.
Right.
It just goes down, and that's the beauty of being fortunate enough to be a teacher and a coach is those kind of things. And Dwayne was he held himself to the highest standard.
He did.
And it's evident in his life and the generations to follow.
He reminded me a lot of Bobby Washington.
Those two
were that fortunate enough to coach Bobby, but he reminded me a lot of Dwayne. You know, for you folks in Sylacauga too, and we're going to have the Kent Fullington, the head basketball coach at Sylacauga, on in the second hour. But Doug is now taking a new job. You know, he was at Auburn. He was the director of high school relations at Auburn. Then he went to Ole Miss. He has just taken the job at Jackson Prep Academy in Jackson, Mississippi. So really excited for Doug Goodwin, Sylacauga High School alumnus, and good guy.
Great guy.
Right?
Got to coach one of his boys in an all-star game. Just great family.
Hey.
Good people.
Congratulations, Doug.
Hey, first hour coming and going. Second hour of the Prep Sports Report is coming up. You will not want to miss it. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
It's time for the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report. Here are your hosts, Coach Rick Cleveland and Coach Mark Lasseter.
And we welcome you back to the Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report, presented by Alpha, and coming to you live from the Eastern Shore Hyundai Centers, today located at the beautiful Timber Creek Golf Club in Daphne, Alabama. I'm Randy Bergen, along with Coach Rick Cleveland, Coach Mark Laster, hanging out with us, the owner and general manager here in Timber Creek, Mr. Rob Bradley. Time to go to our guest on the line, Coach David Armstrong, the head football coach for Baker High School. Coach, how you doing, pal?
Doing fine, and it's basketball, not football. I ain't
enough. I'm sorry. Basketball, my bad. You're absolutely right.
David, Rick Cleveland here, Mark Laster, Randy Bergen. We're really glad to have you on, and I got to tell you the genesis of this. Dear friend of ours, Jack Doss, called me. We were at a tennis tournament in Birmingham, and he called and he said, "Rick, I got to get in touch with Coach Armstrong." And I said, "Well, I don't have David's number, but I know Jeb does." So our principal at the middle school is former head coach out there, and so I called Jeb, and he said, "Yeah, I'll be glad to give it to you. He's one of my favorite people." So sorry we hadn't had you on, but we'll have you on from now on. I can promise you that. You're the number one team in the state of Alabama in 7A, and congratulations for that. And you got probably one of the premier players in the state of Alabama, and you've just had a great season. The last I checked, David, you're 26-3 and headed into your tournament starting this week, right?
Yeah, well, we're 27-3. So we won last night, to be blunt, 58-50 at home for senior night. So that put us at 27-3, finishing out the regular season. And I want to thank you for getting me in touch with Coach Dolph. You know, I answered my phone, and he says, "Coach, this is Jack Dolph from Grissom." I was like, "Hey, Coach." I mean, I'm talking to a man that's won 800-something basketball games. I was excited. I had just won my 100th game, and I'm talking to a guy who's done it, you know, done that 8 times. It's pretty impressive. So thank you for connecting us with him. So hopefully we can find a way to get to play them next year.
Well, he's a good man, and he's a guy that loves the game that you and I both love. He and I coached inner city in Birmingham for several years, and he really had a lot of good things. I tell you what he said. He said, "Rick, I've seen a lot of good players, but from what I understand, this feline kid at Baker is going to be the next Ennis Watley," is what he compared him to. So that's pretty heavy cotton there, Coach.
Yeah, LeBaron's a very impressive player. The fact that he's only a sophomore, he's doing the things he does is, you know, it's fun to watch and fun to be a part of on a regular basis. He's really grown into one heck of a basketball player, and to know that he's just turned 16, got 2 more years of high school to play, you know, it's fun to see, fun to watch. I mean, he scored 40 points against Theodore week before last, which was a school record and a personal best for him. And if you go back, if you can watch that film, it was not an easy 40. It wasn't like somebody gave it to him in transition all night. He had to earn that. And you know, he's the real deal. If you live in Mobile, you live in this area, you need to try to find a way to watch him, because you're going to have to pay to watch him at some point.
Had some buddies who went over and watched him play at Daphne the other night and said, "Rick, he's the real deal, buddy. He's the real deal." So, and he got in foul trouble a little bit early, right?
Yeah, when we played Daphne earlier in the week, he got first offensive possession, he got an off the ball foul on a cut, and I just still ain't even watched the film to see if it was really a foul or not. But that was the very first offensive possession, and then late in the first quarter, it was a legitimate foul. I told him he shouldn't have done it, but we kind of were trying to. I wanted to keep him alive for the whole game, so we've got 2 fouls in the first half. I usually sit you the whole time. I played him a little here and there, tried to offensive, defensive sub him to make sure he stayed out of foul trouble. Getting that third foul in the first half is pretty tough. So he got a slow start, but second half he did what LeBaron does, and, you know, still, I think he scored 29 in that game. So, I mean, it's still a pretty impressive game.
You know, Coach, y'all are having a fantastic year, and I'm just, you know, Baker's a school that has just gotten better and better in sports all around in the last few years. Tell us a little bit about what y'all are doing there to improve your athletic department on a whole scale regimen. You know, y'all guys are all doing things, and your programs are just getting better and better. Tell us some things that y'all are doing.
You know, a big part of it, I think, is, you know, we've got some really good coaches at Baker High School. You know, I'm a Baker grad, so I really have a stake, and I want Baker to be the best. I want Baker to be awesome. You know, I've been around Baker since I was in the 7th grade. You know, our baseball coach, Coach Minto, he also went to Baker. He played and won 2 state titles at Baker for baseball, so he's trying to get baseball back into that spot. Coach Norman, who's been around Baker for, you know, almost 20 years now, is doing everything he can to make our football program great. We've got our athletic director, Coach Curtis, has been there for 15 years or more. You know, we've been around the school, and we all want to see it succeed. We all live in the area. We all want this to be the place to be. The main thing is we've got kids moving in, and kids that are moving into Baker's district that are really good players. You know, if you haven't paid attention to what our sophomore class is in every sport, I'm talking every sport, basketball, baseball, football, soccer, softball. Our sophomore class right now is incredible. LeBaron being one of those. Josh Flowers, the quarterback, who also plays basketball for me. We've got some baseball players that are sophomores, and I can't think of all their names, but they're incredible players. You know, we've got a bright future ahead of us, and we're all excited to see how we're good. And all of us coaches are working together. You know, we've got people playing 2 sports, 3 sports, trying to make sure that we are, you know, putting the best foot forward at Baker High School so that we can win state titles and compete for state titles in every sport, not just baseball and softball like we did in the past. We want to compete in every sport now.
You know, that just warms our heart, I can tell you right now, because we talk about it all the time, kids playing multiple sports, coaches working together, supporting one another. I'm really glad you shared that with us, Coach, and appreciate that information you just gave us on what's going on at Baker High School. That's awesome.
Our senior point guard, Javen Williams, who just signed a football scholarship with Kennesaw State in Georgia, is also going to play baseball in college, but he is a three-sport guy for us at Baker. You know, he played receiver in football, some defensive back as well. He's a point guard / shooting guard for us, averaging, you know, 16 plus a game, scored 19 last night against Blount. And then he's also one heck of a baseball player, plays outfield, can play infield. I think he can pitch a little bit, swings the bat really well. I mean, he's just a stud athlete all the way across, and he's played, you know, two or three sports every year since he's been at Baker. You know, and Josh Flowers plays two sports, and he's, you know, probably the best quarterback in the state of Alabama in his class. You know, we're all about that kind of stuff, Baker. We work hard together to try to make it work.
We're talking to Coach David Andrews, and the head basketball coach at Baker High School. And Coach, we got about a minute here. Talk about your tournament coming up, and then quickly tell us who you expect to see as contenders for the 7A state championship.
So the area tournament starts next week. We are five team areas, so the 4-5 game for us is Davidson versus Bryant, and they will play at Davidson on Tuesday. I can't remember the exact time, but they'll play at Davidson on Tuesday. The winner of that will face us on Thursday at seven at Baker. And before that game, Theodore will play MGM at 5:30. The winners of both of those games will move on to regionals in Montgomery, but we will play an area championship game before that on Saturday at 1:00 at Baker. As far as area tournament, or sorry, moving on through this, I think Theodore's a pretty good basketball team. They're going to be a tough out for anybody, including us. I think Fairhope is getting better. They beat Spanish Florida last week. Teams up north that are good, you got Sparkman and Grissom and Huntsville. They're really good. Oak Mountain, Spain Park, Vestavia Hills, Hoover. There's a lot of teams in those Huntsville, Birmingham area, and Enterprise is also playing really well this year. That was our last loss, actually. So it's going to be a good 7A state tournament. I'm excited to see how this all plays out.
Yeah, well, thinking about you, McGill, Theodore, Spanish Fort in another classification, but we got some really good basketball teams down here. And good luck to you, David. And it's good to connect with you. And we'll be in touch a lot as we move forward in basketball.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate y'all having me on this morning.
Take care. God bless.
All right, there you go right there, Coach David Armstrong, the head basketball coach for Baker High School. And I tell you, man, some good things he's doing over there. There's no question about it. Hey, look, let's take a quick time out. When we come back, Coach, you want to talk some more basketball? Can we do that with Coach Fillington of Sylacauga?
That's what we're going to do.
We're going to do that. Don't you touch that dial. This is PSR.
Welcome back to the Charleston Guest Leonard's Prep Sports Report. Call or text the Prep Sports Report at 251-343-0106 on the Pops Market communication lines. Now, back to the show.
Man, that's some good stuff right there. Hey, welcome back to the Charleston Guest Leonard's Prep Sports Report. My name is Randy Bergen. I am with Coach Mark Laster, Coach Rick Cleveland, owner and general manager of Timber Creek, where we're broadcasting live from today. Mr. Rob Bradley hanging out with us. I got to tell you, hey, Mark, this is the time is flying by. We are having a big time this morning. We're efforting to get in touch with Coach Kent Fullington, the head basketball coach for Sylacauga High School. Of course, right now, all those folks up in the Central Alabama area, you've got us tuned in to Fox Sports Sports Central Alabama on 98.3 FM. Birmingham, Montgomery, Prattville, Auburn, Lake Martin, right there in Sylacauga. That whole Central Alabama area. Glad to have you on board with us, along with the folks along the Gulf Coast of Alabama, Mississippi, Florida. Tuned in to FM Talk 106.5. Could not be happier to be with you. A reminder for you, if you don't mind, I'm going to throw in a little program note. Tomorrow at 11 a.m., be sure and tune in for Southern Fairways Golf Radio Show. We'll be right back here at Timber Creek, getting set a week away, Coach, from our two-man, two-day, two-course Birdies by the Bay golf tournament on the GCGA Tour. We kick it off, and it should be a ton of fun.
Should be, and I do want to mention our buddies out at Quail Creek. Bullpen starts at 10 this morning.
Right.
Did not start early. We had to...
Cold.
All golf courses had to warm up a little bit. So the bullpen is starting at 10. You guys get out there and make a bunch of birdies.
You know, I want to give a little shout out to all these, Rob and all these guys at these golf courses around our area. So wonderful for what they do for high school sports in our area, letting these teams from various schools come out and practice on their course. You know, and all around at Rock Creek, at Lakewood, and Quail Creek, and here at Timber Creek, these guys come out and do a great job. Thank y'all for what you do.
More than welcome.
All right, Mark. Good. Absolutely. Absolutely. Giving of their course time to young men and women to play the game of golf. It's a great investment, I might add.
Yes, sir.
But I think we've got Coach Kent Fullington on from Sylacauga. Coach, good morning, pal.
Hey, how you doing?
Man, we're too blessed to be stressed, as one of our buddies says. So, but we're excited about what's going on with the Aggie basketball program. Talk just a little bit about you. I mean, you end the regular season, I think, 18-8, and you're getting ready for your area tournament now. Tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely. Well, we got lucky enough to win the area, and we put a lot of hard work into that, and we're going to host the area Tuesday and Thursday. We get to host Shelby County. We're the one seed. Shelby's the four. And then Talladega is going to be the home team against Clay Central. They'll play at 6 o'clock, and we're going to play the game following that at 7:30.
Talladega. Now, Chucky Miller has retired. Who's the basketball coach at Talladega now?
Ryan Dawson. So he was the JV/ninth grade coach, and he coached the girls team as well, so he was really familiar with those boys, so it was a seamless transition after Chucky left, and he's done a really good job since being there. He does a good job with those kids.
Talk about your team, Coach. Talk about some of those players. You probably got a couple of seniors that are your leaders, and I know you've just done a heck of a job. I keep hearing really good things from all the people there in Sylacauga, and talk a little bit about your team.
Yeah, we've had several kids step up for us. We run a system that kind of mass subs people in. We want to wear people down in the fourth quarter. But our senior leaders have been great. Hayden Basinger, McCree Taylor. We've had some great seniors step up. Our quarterback, Grayson Edwards. I mean, Hayden Basinger and Grayson Edwards have both shot over 40% from three this year. McCree's been an absolute stud from our press perspective. He's the lead of our – he's the point of our press. And he's kind of the guy that handles the ball and pushes it in transition. Caden Foreman's been a guy down low that's really given us a lot. We've had some new faces to step up. And, you know, like we've had sophomores, Jakarian Cottingham and Connor Twyman and Quindavious Swain and Jamari Jeffries. And these are kids that I didn't think or foresee that they were going to get significant high minutes, you know, as sophomores on the varsity level. But, you know, they've really stepped up for us. And we've got two juniors on the team that have just been studs for us all year, Grant Hickey and Jay Campbell. And I've just been really, really impressed, and probably the hardest working kid on our team, I can't leave him out, is Jeremy Odom. And he's another guy that kind of brings a surge of energy in our wave. He's kind of in the second, and the more, like, we play two waves essentially, and he brings just a burst off the bench. He's been one of our leading rebounders. And I've just been very, very pleased with these kids all year. We actually broke the school record this year of 3-point shots made. We made 16 threes in one game against Talladega. So I've been really proud with the kids and the work they put in. We play a very fast style. It's attacking nonstop. We want to attack you the whole game, offensively and defensively. So we get that ball down the floor in a hurry. It's a fun brand to watch.
Well, I can tell you this, Coach. Thank goodness they didn't have the three-shot line in the 70s. There were a bunch of us that have probably been benched because we tried to break that record back in the 70s. They didn't have that shot in those days.
Definitely, for sure. But it's been a great year so far, and we've had a great three-year run. I mean, year one, we went to a regional final, and year two, we went to a Final Four last year, and year three is set up for us to make another run. We just got to worry about, you know, our core values and doing what we do every single day in practice. But I've been really pleased, and, you know, Sylacauga is very special in my heart. It's a place that not a lot of people know about. It's a diamond in the rough. It's just a little piece of heaven, man. It's just everybody in this town is so supportive of one another, and everybody genuinely shows up and wants you to be successful in whatever you're doing. And I've been so thankful to have gotten the opportunity to coach these kids here and be a part of this community.
Well, it's a great little town. It's a great town to grow up in, Coach. And I want you to know how proud we are, those of us who are no longer there but love Sylacauga. And every chance we get, we check every media outlet we can check to see how you're doing in basketball. And you've done nothing but impress those of us who graduated from there and love that school. So thank you for what you've done.
I want you to do me one favor.
There's a young man there that's a baseball player. His dad listens to our show, been listening to us for years. Brantley Brasher, go put your arm around him and tell him that the PSR staff in Mobile congratulates him on signing a baseball scholarship with Bethel.
Best kids in that school, man. That kid, so I'll tell you a story. We got the opportunity this year to do our Friday, in the preseason, our Friday competition days with the baseball team. And just about every drill, just about every game, his teams, him and Jake Hammond both, their teams are always winning it. I'm sitting there, I'm just like, man, these are leaders that I want affecting my team. And that's what they did. By us competing with the baseball team, it allowed us to get a lot better and grow as leaders a lot better. And he's had such a positive impact every single day at that school. And that's, you know, the reflection of Coach Bell and the job he does over there. But more importantly, the kind of kid Brantley is too. And man, I'm excited to go watch the baseball team this spring for sure, no doubt. I'll relay that message to him.
Thanks a bunch, pal. Take care, Kent. God bless.
Absolutely. Talk soon.
All right, there you go. Coach Kent Fullington, the head basketball coach for Sylacauga High School. I got to tell you, just listening to that interview right there, this coach is very energetic. He would be fun to hang out with. I don't think there's a question about it. And Rick, I couldn't help but notice, as he was talking about Sylacauga, you were just sitting over there with a big old, I just stole somebody's cheesecake smile.
Absolutely.
That's a special town. I'm telling you guys, that was a special time to grow up in Sylacauga. You know, Philip Rivers is down here now. His dad, Steve, Mark, you could hit a wedge from my house to Steve's house.
I couldn't.
Well, it's not
You've
about 50 yards, Mark.
Coach, have you seen me swing a club?
Yeah, well, maybe a driver. Maybe you could hit a driver there. But anyway, you had people like that growing up there. And I mean, sports, it was a sports town.
Listen, we were talking about golf just a little bit ago. Yeah. One of the most fabulous golf courses anywhere around in the United States, right there in Sylacauga, Farm Links. If you've not played there, you definitely need to put that on your list.
Well, now, I don't like to correct you because you are right 99% of the time.
It's outside of Sylacauga.
It is. It's in Fayetteville. Yeah. But a Sylacauga family started that. The Purcell family started that. And it is a beautiful golf course.
But you associate it with Sylacauga.
That's right. Right down Highway 280. That's exactly right. But when you talk to the Purcells, they want to make sure that we say Fayetteville because it's the thriving – it's the center of that little small community.
It is a neat little ride up as you're winding your way back. Hey, look here. They got Longhorns out there, right? That's their logo.
That's right.
That's their logo.
Thank you for mentioning that.
Yeah. Let's take a quick time out. When we come back, y'all want to get into something?
Sure. Yeah.
We're going to put a question mark on what that is, okay?
Yes.
Don't go anywhere. You got to tune in to the Prep Sports Report.
Welcome back to the Charleston Guest Lanterns Prep Sports Report, presented by Alpha Insurance. Here are your hosts, Coach Rick Cleveland and Coach Mark Lassiter.
And we welcome you back to Charleston Gaslighters Prep Sports Report, coming to you live from Timber Creek Golf Club in beautiful Daphne, Alabama. I am Randy Bergen, along with Coach Rick Cleveland, Coach Mark Laster, Rob Bradley, the owner and general manager, hanging out here at Timber Creek. Man, I'll tell you what, guys, it is just flying by. Time to go back to our Pops Midtown Communications line and welcome in the girls' basketball coach for UMS Wright, Coach Terry Canova. Coach, how you doing, pal?
Hey, good morning, guys. Good to be with you.
Hey, we threw you a curve there, didn't we? You thought it was going to be my nappy voice coming on, and it's a real radio voice, isn't it? That's good stuff. That's kind of like we have improved. Like your basketball team seems to just peak at the end of the season. You've had a tremendous season, Terry, and you know those seniors. You've got Anna McAnally and Carabeth Green and Avery Beasley, and then you look at Campbell Johnson and Dorsey Parker. What great leadership you've had, and I know you're down in New Orleans today, but
I am.
Talk just a little bit about this basketball team. I told Terry the other day, I'm telling you guys, he's the best I've ever been around coaching girls basketball, but he could coach a men's
team anywhere, anything, and excellent coach.
Just,
well,
man,
you guys are too kind. I'm very, very blessed to be where I'm at. You know, just starting with the seniors, as many of you guys know, we had one of our seniors go down with a season-ending injury on Saturday. And you want to talk about stepping up in leadership? Well, Campbell Johnson, who has now we moved into starting lineup to replace Avery Beasley. Campbell has led all scorers in the last two games, and so you know I think the thing that has driven us all season has been our depth, and that's just a perfect example. When you lose a kid, the quality of Avery Beasley. And her backup comes in and now is leading all scorers in the last two games. I mean, that just says a little bit about how many good players we have.
You know, Terry, as you go into the area tournament, talk just a little bit about that. I know we'll host that at UMS Wright, but talk just a little bit about how the bracket looks. And you know, of course, the winner and runner-up advance. So you really need to win is it the first game in this? If you win the first one, you get to the finals. How does that work?
Correct, Rick. So with the four team area, we'll begin on Tuesday night. St. Paul's will play Faith Academy at 6 p.m. at UMS, and then we'll play Satsuma at 7:30. And for those not familiar with how it works in Alabama, so the winner of the area tournament hosts a sub-region playoff game, and the loser in the championship, the second-place team, travels in the sub-region playoff. Like, for instance, last year, St. Paul's defeated us in the finals, and so we had to go to LaFleur, who was the Area 1 winner. We're excited about Tuesday night. You know, I mean, we're the one seed, so we get the four seed, but you know, Satsuma and Justin Harrison. And Justin Harrison has done an outstanding job with them. I think they've won the last six or seven games. They play really, really well. And like I told our kids yesterday, I mean, half the teams in the state are going to be turning in uniforms after this game. You know, so it's important for us. You know, we've beaten Satsuma twice. We've had some success with them, but you can't look past them. You know. You can't look past them. You've got to take every game serious. And, you know, like they say, it's survive in advance now.
So both of these games will be played at UMS Wright, 6 and 7:30 on Tuesday night. And then the winner will host the sub-region. The runner-up will play Area 1. Who's in that area? Or that region.
And you know, I keep saying LaFleur, and I don't want to discredit. In Area 1 is LaFleur, BC Rain, and Alberta. Now, right now, so far, LaFleur is the clear-cut leader. They've beaten both Alberta and BC Rain both times. So in the past, in the last couple of years, it's kind of been in the girls' side, but LaFleur has been kind of the clear-cut winner in Area 1. and then BC Rain and Alberta have been kind of battling it out for that second spot.
Right. Well, so the winner obviously will play at home, and the loser will go probably to LaFleur.
Yes, sir.
And the winner will play.
You know, last year, that kind of propelled us. You know, we finished second, and we were licking our wounds a little bit from losing in the finals, and then we went to LaFleur and won, and that kind of propelled us in the playoffs. You know, kind of gave us a little mojo and helped us with some confidence to beat the number one team in the state last year, Central Tuscaloosa.
Now, state, are we still playing the state tournament in Birmingham? Have we moved that to a different location?
No, Rick.
The Final Four,
COVID, everything, you know, anything could change. But right now, the Final Four is still slotted for the BJCC.
Okay.
You know, then you also have your four regionals. You know, we're in the Southwest, which will be in Montgomery. They've kind of been tweaking with that a little bit. Alabama State was the host, but now I'm seeing, that may be adjusted a little bit. They're still tweaking a little bit because of COVID, and I guess, you know, different venues have different COVID regulations. Heck, we'll go play at the corner of Dolphin and Sage if we got to. I just love coaching this team, and we'll play wherever we got to play.
Well, you got a great bunch of girls, Terry, and I haven't taught them all. Absolutely, think the world of them, and golly, I know Mark. I know Mark feels the same way. He knows most of these youngins, and so
yeah. I just took Terry. I enjoyed watching y'all play the other night when you came to over to Bayside, and I just the unselfishness of your team is so apparent, and how those girls pass that ball off and work each other open. Then they come off the bench, they get their time, they do the same thing. It's from top to bottom, and it's just impressive, buddy. And of course, you know how I feel about you and what you've always done, and I just think you guys are doing a fantastic job this year.
Well, thanks, Mark. I didn't think offensively we played very well at Bayside the other night, and I think I told you that, but man, our defensive energy, I mean, Brittany does a good job there at Bayside, and they got a couple good players, but we just, it was almost like we had so much defensive energy, and it was like, you know, they just never got a breather, you know, because, you know,
right.
My kids, man, they play so hard for me, and you're right, you know, it doesn't matter who I put in. They're going to come in and compete, and they're going to play hard. And I think that's the thing that's driven us all year, even on nights when we don't shoot the ball particularly well. Man, our defensive energy and our pressure can get after you a little bit. And so that's kind of what we're leaning on.
You know, Terry, one of the things, I want to mention some of these other kids. Noah Freeman, I mean, she comes in and backs up Dorsey and does a great job. And then the Metter girls, you bring those Metter girls, and they can shoot the eyes out of it. They absolutely shoot the eyes out of it. And Bailey Washington, she's tenacious on defense. I love these kids. Emily Wolf comes in, and Adam McNally, a senior who comes off the bench. I love the way you guys shoot the three, and I mean, they don't pass up threes. If they've got it, they take it.
Well, you're right. And one of my concerns the other night at Bayside was I had Elizabeth and KB pass up a three early in the game. I think that, you know, their confidence dipped a little bit because we've been in a little bit of a slump. And I told them, I said, what you've got to do is understand every game is a new game. You can't base what you do the first possession of a basketball game on what happened in the last game. And so so we're working on that a little bit, and we had a really good practice yesterday, and we're shooting the ball extremely well. But you're right. My second five, and you know, again, coaches can't win without good players. We all know that. My second five, could a lot of those kids could start for some high school teams. You know, so our depth is
That's
pretty
right.
good. And just trying to get them minutes is a fun chore.
That's the hardest job for a coach, isn't it, buddy?
Absolutely.
That's the
is.
Hardest job for a coach. Terry, hey, look, you just have a great time with your beautiful wife there in New Orleans, and be safe coming home. And we look forward to seeing you Monday, pal. Take care.
Hey, thanks some Cafe so much. Dumont. I appreciate it. Love you guys. Thanks for what you do.
Thanks,
Take
buddy.
Care.
There you go, Coach Terry Canova, the girls' basketball coach for UMS Wright. Great guy. Great.
Just love talking.
Yeah, there's no doubt.
You know, let me pay some bill here real quick.
Do that,
local
please.
Local attorney Braxton Counts is a lobbyist in both Montgomery, Alabama and Washington, D.C. Braxton has joined forces with former Tennessee Congressman Jimmy Duncan to assist you with all governmental affair problems. Both of these gentlemen have great influence in both Montgomery and Washington, and many of you rely on either the state or the federal government for your businesses. Braxton and Jimmy can put you in front of the right people to assist you. It's all about relationships, and both Braxton and Jimmy have those connections to assist you. Give Braxton Counts a call at 251-476-9900.
Hey, Coach, I got to tell you right now, I can tell that mine and Mark's relationship is getting a little tested, but someone will bring him back in here a little bit.
Randy, I'm be a wrestling coach.
Hey, I'm telling you, man. Hey, no, listen, there's something coming up, Coach, that I know is pretty special to a lot of us. Yeah, it happens in just a couple of weeks on February the 21st, 22nd. Going back to golf for just a second.
Yeah.
UMS Wright is going to host the David Miller Memorial, all right? And it'll be at Lakewood. And Coach, there'll be a list of high schools that will be participating, including Bayside.
Yes, it's a big tournament, and Adam Bain does a great job at UMS Wright. He puts on this tournament. The David Miller Memorial is a great tournament. It has a lot of meaning to a lot of people, and it's one that we relish playing in every year. And it'll be a great tournament. Some of the best teams in the state of Alabama will be here in that tournament, and we look forward to seeing that get kicked off on February 21st at Lakewood.
Yeah, it should be a lot of fun.
Thank you for mentioning it, Adam. He does a great job.
He's a fantastic guy.
And I want you to invite me out for supper that night, okay?
Sure. Absolutely. It's on UMS. I'll invite you.
Hey, look, this is going by too fast. You got to hang tight. When we come back, it is a very special segment. It's the faith segment. Coach Mark Laster's got that for you when we come back right here on PSR.
This segment of the Charleston Gas Lanterns Prep Sports Report, brought to you by Camp Grace. Now back to Coach Rick Cleveland.
Camp Grace is located in West Mobile as the summer home of Camp Rapahope, Camp Mash, Camp Smile, and Camp Sugar Falls, as well as the home of Outback Mobile, and is shared by many other community organizations throughout the Mobile area. Camp Grace is a place where God's love is bestowed freely upon others, the true definition of God's grace.
So, this morning, I'm just telling you, all week long, it's kind of been impressed upon me. What are we supposed to be doing? Period. What do we do to edify the spirit of those around us? We've talked about this many, many times. Personally, Rick, you and I talk about it all the time, about what we're supposed to be doing as human beings. What is laid out for us? I keep going back to the Golden Rule, which I think is the reason it's called the Golden Rule, is because it's pretty special. In everything, do unto others what you would have them to do unto you. It's Matthew 7:12 in the Bible. And it's important that I think about that every day. Because too many times, I don't know about you guys, but for me, I have a tendency to get out of myself and start looking at others around me instead of looking at Mark first. You know, how am I behaving? How am I treating other people? You know, I think about this thing with Brian Harsin right now, and it just irks my soul. I see, and it happens way too, not just with him, but all across this country. It happens every single day. I don't even want to watch the news anymore. All we talk about is the terrible things that people do to one another. Why not talk about the good stuff? Why can't we talk about that? Why can't we look and see? I know what Rick Cleveland teaches. You know, he don't even know this. I know what he teaches in his class at school every day. He teaches leadership and character. And I guarantee you there is more shared out of his heart than there is any book that can be written. And it is so much more meaningful to those kids, because kids want to know your heart. They like knowledge. Kids respect knowledge. they love the heart of the people sharing with them. That's what they love. That's what I've learned. And it took me a long time to learn it. My gosh, if we could, Rick, if we could go back and teach a class to young coaches about what our job really is, it's not about moving up the ladder. It's not about the print in the newspaper, or it's not a newspapers anymore. Right. That's just a whole line. Or online. It's about what I can do to influence the life of a child that's standing right in front of me. That kid who is on our golf team, who's going to shoot a 71, 72, 70 every time he goes out, to the kid that can't break 100 right now.
That's right.
That kid still's going to, that's somebody's child. And it's been, and I've been given the responsibility to teach him something. Now, as all three of you well know, I cannot teach any of them to swing a golf club. Y'all have seen my golf swing. I can't teach any of them. But what I can teach them is some experiences that I've learned in my own life about how to overcome adversity. Also, how to handle the good times. Gene Stallings said it best. You know, he said it the best. The game of football, you know, has great things, but it's how we learn how to handle the good times and the bad times that mark our character. When you throw that 75-yard touchdown pass and you run into the end zone, that's a great thing, and everybody's cheering, everybody's happy. How do you handle that? Is it about you, or is it about your team? Or if you're the guy who got called for holding on that penalty. Adversity has struck. What are you going to do as teammates? Y'all going to jump on his back and ride him down? Or are you going to pat him on the back? He'll do better next time. You ever heard that line? That comes from an old excerpt. I think that was, I don't remember where it was from, but Coach Sav used to read it all the time.
All the time.
Every ball game.
Yep.
But actually, Willie Carl Martin read it at Benjamin Russell for years. He was the one who Sav had read it. But anyway, but my whole point this morning is, what are we doing, folks? What are we doing? That's why I love doing this radio show. That's why I think this radio show is so important. Randy's is the same. Randy does the same type thing. Everything is about being positive and uplifting the ones around us. We don't have, there's too many people out there beating people down. You know, I've been through times in my life when people have beat me down. And there's people that have beat me up. Said, go. You've done a great job, you know. How do I handle that? Is it good or bad? What do you do? Man, it's so easy if you just get up, and every morning before you get up, you read that little deal about, I'm going to treat others today like I want them to treat me. God told me how to do that. Yeah. It's real simple. The Bible is nothing but a playbook. It's got a playbook, and it's got one for everything that you can face. And what it is, you know, sometimes, Rick, you and I have talked about this a bunch. And, Randy, I've talked with this about Randy. Sometimes it's stuff we don't even want to face. And the answer I get may not be what I want to hear. I don't want to hear that. Patience, Mark. Patience. You got to be patient. Well, I want it now.
Right.
You know, I want the peace and the grace and all that to happen right now. I don't want to have to face this adversity today. Take it away. No, you're going to have to face it.
Yeah.
Because you got to learn something.
Yeah. That's
and if I do, I'll learn it. And, guys, thank you all for giving me a few minutes to share this stuff this morning, because it is on my heart. I'm hurting for people today. I hurt for people because I think people are getting beat up for no reason. Just because other people like to beat other people down because it makes them feel better about who they are, or it gives them something that they want. My God, how do you ruin people like that?
You know, Mark, the people that do that beating up are the ones that are hurting the most.
Yes, they are.
They're the ones that are hurting the most. You probably heard this. Our buddy Spence McCracken, a few years ago in his acceptance speech of some award in Montgomery, he said, I wish I would have been kinder to my competitors.
Yes, yes.
I wish I would have been... Golly, that resonates with me.
Me too.
I mean, it resonates
me too.
With me.
I'll tell you something else, Coach. Ralph Watson taught me something. Our basketball coach and our assistant football at Bayside, he's made the statement, hurt people, hurt people.
That's true.
Wow, that's pretty good right there.
That's right. It's exactly right.
That's exactly what we're saying.
Right.
That's what Spence was saying.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. Hurt people, hurt people. That's exactly right. Guys, funny, we just talked about that leadership this week.
Yeah. I know what you teach in your class.
Vince Lombardi said that. Vince Lombardi said that one of his regrets when he finished coaching was that remember his famous second place is losers?
Yes. Right.
He said he regretted that he said that.
Right.
And I think what he meant by that was that no matter what place you come in, if you left it all on the field you conducted yourself with character,
that's right,
then you're a winner.
That's right.
And I think that's very important as well in this discussion. And and the truth is what we're really talking about.
Yes.
When a day's done. And we all are a little bit uncomfortable with the truth. But when we learn that we embrace the truth, it makes us all better.
You know, it's one of the things you said, Mark. It's termed, I guess, bully or whatever. But, you know, there's a lot of folks out there, and you know who they are. They know who they are. When they have to beat you up to make them look good, really makes them look bad.
It does.
Okay? Makes you look even better.
Amen.
All right? So
that's it.
Hey, I want to tell you how this is awesome. Real. This is real. Rob, thank you so much for this venue.
Oh, anytime.
This is,
you're more than
don't
welcome.
Don't say that.
It's an open invitation.
Don't you say that.
Hey, I'm all about what y'all are about.
Next Saturday, we're going to be at Lake Forest as we get set for our GCGA tournament.
Randy, we always end the show like this, and I don't want to take it. I want you to adopt this. No matter what you do, no matter where you go, he is always with you.
Amen.
God bless you. We'll see you next week.